Okay guys, this video is about, because I'm doing a lot of alterations for myself, because I finally start, I went on a more strict diet and thinking to go back pandemic or not, but I cannot exercise much with gravity just killing me, you know, while I have to go back in the swimming pool, it's reopened in the gym, and have to go back and swim and try to figure out a safe way of doing it without going to any changing room. Well, but anyway, I'm losing weight, because that's the reason why I'm doing a lot of alterations, and you end up, because I have to show to you whatever I'm doing, I have to show to you what you will know that as well. Okay, this is a today video is about how easiest way to turn men's shirt to ladies' one. And why we after men's short? Why we not satisfied with ladies' ones? Because I told you already, and I will repeat as many times as is need to make my point through, what more quality these days in a men's garment as in ladies, especially when we talk about cotton and medium weight and heavier weight cotton. Like this short, for this is a short what we're working on, and I just fall in love with it. I got in a thrift store, and it's Ralph Lauren stripes cut. It's a heavy weight cotton, which is totally like you cannot fight. And you know, Ralph Lauren always about stripes. And look how beautiful the stripes are. They are so spaced out. They are so different. And because I am doing videos now, right now I'm very busy with dyeing fabrics, dyeing garments with different dyes, synthetic and naturals. And I do have bright yellow dye. And eventually after I'm done with this blouse making out of men's short, what I will do, I will put some borders here. I will dye some spots here on the sleeves and around neck. But that's in future, because my goal always, if I do anything on one piece of garment, to make like two, three videos out of it, to show to you different problems on the same piece of garment, to guide you through all this good fit, good look, what you can use in your life. And what we can do, easiest way possible. Easiest way possible. First of all, cut out your color. You know, men's stand up looking color. Cut down to this point when it's come to like in this blouse, which is, again, I believe garage sale I got. It still was brand new, still had tags attached to it, and it's so soft, so comfortable. Now it's time to wear it. Finally, it's cool off in California, a long sleeve blouse. And make to stand up color like that. I always suggest you to do it, because a stand up color never belongs to ladies' garment. But in my case, I did not even do that. Why? Because that was worn out color. That was some kind of signs of warning on it. I did not want to keep not little piece of it. No, while I took whole color out, completely whole color out. And after I did that, what else you can do? Obviously, because it's got, after I took color, it was become too close to the neck, and I cannot stand nothing too close to the neck. That's why I took it also, I cut also these little corners right here to make it down a little bit like that. It's still ladylike, but I don't have that choking me color there. Next, what you will deal with, I cut my sleeves to a little bit below elbow sleeve, but you can do longer. You still can have your long sleeve. Just get rid of this uncomfortable thing, because it's so uncomfortable around your wrist, all this stuff, right? When you have just cut it off, just cut off to this point at least, where is this opening finished. To this point, it's going to be about right here somewhere on you, and just close with half inch hem, like a very easy rolled up hem to close, make difference in the world. And what I like when I'm turning men's shorts to my blouses, they very roomy. It's only larger size, and I am 2XL now on the top, but look how roomy is this here. So roomy. When you reach, hug somebody, you do some activities, and because this cotton is don't stretch, it's give you all kind of room to do it, all kind of room. And that's what I like about men's shorts. And what else? On the back, on the men's short, we'll have this big huge pleat going on all the way from here. On the ladies, this cut usually go down, or it's not at all. What I suggest, you stitch it. See what I did? I stitched that pleat together. And I don't think I got enough. I should go a little bit down, like maybe like 4 inches from end of armpit right here, and stitch it right here on the corner like that, to keep it up with that, not gonna be pokering on your back, nothing, but it's gonna be nice and flat back. What else left? I have to close this with something, this neckline with something, because it's such a heavy cotton shirt, and I already in love with it. Will be such a good weekender with a blue denim jacket and washout jeans, just beautiful. And what I'm gonna use to close this neckline? Well, I'm gonna use this piece of nothing I got again for dollar on garage sale. It's a tablecloth, but it's linen, it's beautiful. It's not useful for me as it is. Now, well, what I can do from, because this lace I can use eventually some on the road. I just pray what God let me live that long enough to see that eventually, to use for some custom made, because it's a beautiful job right here. It's all hand job, and I really want to keep that kind of, preserve this kind of vintage stuff. But in the middle right here, this piece is not really useful. And what I can do, I can cut my piece off to cover that neck cut somewhere right here in the middle from this, because I like texture. It's matching this texture of fabric. And that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put like that together, because I have to follow shape of this neckline. You do like that, you put together, and see how fast tailor I am. I just don't spend too much time to cut it out. I just do it all in one shot. Well, my customer's dream is one of my subscribers. Thank you for question, by the way. Ask me, is it any justification for doing this way, not the usual tailor's way? Yes, it is, my customers, because, you know, when you've been running such a busy tailor shop for so long, almost 30 years, your customers just want everything done now. Otherwise, they don't want it all. That's why I train to do it, all the shortcuts and everything else. Well, you just mark it right here. I have black tailor shock. You make sure you got something extra here, at least 1 inch. If you don't have tailor shock like I do, you use something else, such as a pencil will do good, better as pen. Make sure you have 1/2 inch here on the stitching seam, and about 1 inch there, what we can finish nice. And after you draw that, what you need to do at least, because I want to have good, not rolling over stitch, well, at least 1 inch. What it's mean? It's mean actually I need a width of it to have 1.5 inches. Something like that, 1.5 inches. Cut it out. And let me go to machine and show you how to fix it up. And this is the fastest way possible. Well, it is a lot of ways of doing it, and we will try. I will one little bit by little bit, one video after another. I will explain to you a lot of stuff about it, but right now that's what we have. Okay, guys, here we go by sewing machine. And well, what I do, I put this piece, as you can see, I hemmed up. I just put little stitch right here to close this piece what we cut it to close neckline, just like that, 1/4 inch. I torn and I stitch it. What is this piece will be ready for me to close up, and then I pin it to the neckline, and I'm stitching front to front, stitching with tiny little seam, no more is 1/4 inch. I'm going even less as 1/4 inch attachment. Okay, now when this piece attached, what I need to do, I just need to cut excess. I'll only about 1 inch here to close up nicely. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna turn like that. I'm gonna turn 1/2 inch in. Now, you know what? Okay, guys, now when this piece attached all around, what you're gonna do, you just leave 1 inch here, no more is 1 inch, and turn this way, okay? Turn under this piece, under, I do have button loop here and button which is will be not usable after I finish with this neckline. That's exactly my idea, because top one I don't want to close up. It's gonna be just fake looking one, because it's such a heavy cotton, it's gonna stay like that. And my last one wooden up will be right here. Now, well, after you straight up this one by end practically, you turn it like that, okay? And that's how it's gonna be attached. That's how it's gonna be attached. Make sure it's gonna lay flush with that end of it. Flush with that end of it, exactly. Like that, okay? Like that, okay? I suggest you first stitch on the very end, right here about quarter inch away from it, and then you're gonna finish it up on the bottom. When you stitch this quarter inch, see how nice? I just make short video how to make it such a nice stitch right here without any measurement at all whatsoever, very close and exactly quarter inch away from that end. Now you can turn, and what you can do, you can stitch this corner and start stitching and along the edge and make it nice looking neck. Okay guys, here you are, that's what's come up. Really beautiful, really beautiful. It's simplest line again, it's the thousands of ways of doing it. I showed to you in this video simplest way to do it, and it does look a little bit like a baseball uniform or something, right? That's why I decide when I will start dyeing stuff, I will already started, but this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna add a little bit yellow of dye pattern here and some yellow pattern here around neck to break that style. And you will tell me, Ralph Lauren, it's all about stripes, classic, and dyeing fabric, it's all about hobo style, right? Or gypsy style, I call it. Well, not really, because remember I told you one of my early videos, I told you what, if you can mix something two styles which is don't go together, and you mix in one, sometime it's work perfect, because it does give you that shape, sense of different style, something like nobody have it, and it's definitely nobody will have something like that. Okay guys, now well, thank you for your time, thank you for watching. Please subscribe if you don't subscribe yet, because a lot more coming, and already so many things on the channel, a lot more videos coming. Thank you for your time.